Hi, my name is Katrina Marie, and my husband had this wonderful fish dish at a restaurant. It was cod and sea bass casino. So they took the clams casino mix on top of the clams and they poured that right over the fish or put it on the fish and they baked it. So we're gonna make our homemade version of that. So what you do, because everyone was asking him because it was so delicious, I melted one stick of butter. So we're gonna put that in a pan because this pan isn't big enough. I'm gonna put red and yellow peppers. I don't like green because they repeat on you too much. Then we're going to put, now I have 2 tablespoons of garlic because I'm making 2 pans, but usually it's 1. And I just put the tablespoon of lemon juice in it because it's both liquid. Pour that on top. We're going to mix this in real good. Okay? Now, these are dried shallots, which I love because they don't go bad. And I put them in everything. It has a really pleasant taste to it. We'll pour that on top. Then I have Emerald's fish rub in there. A teaspoon of lemon dashes, lemon pepper to give it that lemony taste. And I use 2 tablespoons of this. Okay, and I'm gonna just use 1 teaspoon of salt. Okay, when you pour your seasoning, especially dried ones, make sure you mix them up good so you don't get one spot that's saltier than the other. You don't have, if it sticks. So I'm just gonna put this in like a liquid butter. Now I also have bacon that we crumbled. We fried that already and we crumbled it. Parmesan cheese and breadcrumbs. I also have chicken broth, which I'm going to put on the bottom of the pan so that when we bake this, it doesn't curl up the fish on the end because it gets dry. That's really not tasty and pleasant. So now we're going to mix this real good. Make sure our mixing is very important. Blend, blend, blend. Just like when you put makeup on, ladies. What do they say? Blend. You don't want one spot more than the other. Now I'm going to fry this until it gets tender. I might add a little chicken broth at the end of it. I'm going to put this, and we're going to keep turning it. Doesn't that look fabulous?
Yeah, I'm hungry.
Look at how colorful that is. All the seasoning and the butter.
That's good already.
You know what? I think that I'm going to add 1 tablespoon of olive oil only because I don't want this to burn. And that helps your butter not turn brown, okay?
Okay.
So we're just going to add 1 tablespoon of oil, olive oil, just so my butter doesn't burn if I make the flame a little higher to get this going. And then I'm going to mix that in the bottom. Olive oil is good for you, so that will help. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of make it nice and even. You could do this in a pot, too, if you want. But I'm doing it in a frying pan so you guys can really see it. Okay, so let's bring it over to the stove. Okay, I've got that frying on high. When I start hearing it snap, then I'll turn it down a little bit. And so while you're waiting, we're going to put two cups of breadcrumbs, right? Because I'm doubling this recipe, so you can use 1 cup. And then I'm going to put like 1 cup of Parmesan cheese, because I love me some Parmesan cheese. I'll use this one. Mix, mix, mix. Blend, blend, blend. Right? And then when that's done, we'll pour that on, when the frying pan is done with all the vegetables, we'll pour that on top. Now what I'm also going to do is, this bacon has cooled off. I might throw that in the frying pan just to get it a little, you know, soak in some of the spices and stuff, and then put it on here. So we're done. You know what? I changed my mind. I'm going to put the bacon in here and coat it with the Parmesan cheese. Don't you think that would be delicious, right? See, I cook by instinct, whatever I'm feeling in the moment. So So I'll change recipes, eyeball things, add stuff. See, now if I coat it with the cheese, it'll melt on the bacon when it's on the fish. What do you think? Does that sound delicious?
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm starting to hear that vegetables getting up with the heat there. Okay. Okay. So let me go over this again. So you're going to need shallots. Okay. And we use 2 tablespoons. A little bit of lemon pepper, 1 tablespoon. Teaspoon. 1 teaspoon of lemon pepper. Fish rub, 2 tablespoons. Lemon. You can use fresh or this. We used 1 tablespoon. We used 1 cup of chicken broth. We had red and yellow peppers. 2 tablespoons of olive oil. A stick of butter. And 1/2 teaspoon of salt. One teaspoon of salt. See, because I go by the seat of my pants, I gotta remember what I just put in. I use 2 tablespoons of crushed garlic. Hear that? Snapping over there. Okay, let's go check. Okie dokie, look at this. Mmm, it's starting to smell good, just like Clam's Casino, but like the Royale kind.
Yeah, it does.
Not your clam bar kind of cheesy one. It's like the kind you serve the queen. So I turned it from high to about 7, but you have to know your own stove. And we'll just like try to get the peppers a little more tender. See that? Look at that. Wonderful. Blend, blend, blend. So then when we put in the dry ingredients, it's not gonna have one spot with more spices or salt. All right, I think that's good. Look at that. Doesn't that look delicious? Now, we did this for the holidays as one of the fish dishes for Christmas Eve. So it looks very festive. Now, if you want to be daring and throw in any kind of jalapeno peppers or a little crushed red pepper, that's up to you. You can really go with what your personal taste is. You know, if you like a little zing, see now the bacon, want to get it so it's not dry anymore. Mix, mix, blend, blend. Now what we're going to do is we're just going to coat this on top of the fish just like you would do for clams. Now also I want to try, I haven't tried it, my husband, I have to watch with him. I was going to mix like canned crab meat in there. You could probably put baby shrimp. You know, and then put it on top. He's shaking his head no. Like, don't mess with my recipe. But, you know, this is what I'll do. I'll experiment with a side dish, do my fish like that, and then he tastes it and goes, that was really good. Can you do it like that next time? But I can't mess with him at first. He has to try a sample. If I do the whole thing, he'll get mad at me for ruining it. That's what he says. Okie dokie. So we mixed it up. This is what you do. Put it right on the fish, you pound it in, right? That's all you do. And then you bake it in the oven. I do 300 for half an hour. Then you do 5 minutes on broil to just crust, like they do with the clams. You know, spread it around. And let me tell you, there's not a piece left when you put this out for everyone. You could put, if you don't like the shallots, you could put chopped onions, like I said. You can make it hot, you can make it, see the peppers are sweeter. I don't like green peppers, that's bitter and it repeats on you. So do this.
That's perfect.
Okay, I decided that I'm gonna speed this up a little bit, so I'm gonna go to 350 for 20 minutes. We'll see how it goes and then we'll broil just the top real quick. To brown it. Alright, so I put it on convection bake, 350. Now, if you put the timer on, it won't shut the oven off if you get distracted. But if you have this feature, cooking time, you click that and you say 20 minutes. So if you get distracted or the phone rings and you forget the oven's on, you won't burn your dinner, it will automatically shut it off and hold it. so then it tastes delicious and you don't ruin your dinner. Okay, I'm gonna give you a little tip. When you have to go out somewhere, some people like cooking together in a big crowd. Other people don't like all that confusion in their kitchen. My family, we cook our meals at home and then we bring it warm to the house and we can start eating right away and there's no pots to clean or anything. It's really, really nice. But what you need to do then is you can get this. This is an insulated bag because that's pretty big. You open it up and I'm gonna slide that fish right in there, hot from the oven, bring it to my sister's house a half an hour away, take it out and put it right on the table. No microwaving, no having to use her oven. She might not have enough room. She might have her own food in there. She also bought me this, which is fabulous. It had its own pan. So say you cook brownies or anything in this. And then you cook it with a tin foil on top, you take that off, you put it in here. Sometimes if it's really hot, you may not want to do this unless it's like cake or brownies and it's not too hot. But you put this on here, and then when you do this, right? I'm sure you could get them on Amazon. You just bring it to their house, all done, all heated, nobody gets burned. It's wonderful. That's one of my tips about cooking. And I'm gonna put on that, I saved these from the caterers. I'm gonna put that on the fish so that, you know, when I put it in the bag, it's not sliding around and spilling all over the inside of the bag. Okie doke, that's my tip for how to transfer hot dishes. Okay, so now this is the way it looks. Just like you would have baked clams, but the fish is underneath. So we're gonna put this, you gotta go. Otherwise I'm gonna shoot me. And then we're gonna open our bag. We're gonna slide it in. And we're gonna go. And we're gonna put it right on their table.
Let's go.
So I hope you enjoy this recipe. And if you want to put comments about how you've either added things or how you feel it works for you, then just put comments below or post you like it, five star it, and I appreciate you spending this time with me.
Right, what do you think of that fish, Mia?
It's good.
That's a chow.
Ooh. You made it.
Oh, I love the chow.
Leprosy.
Ah, you like it?
Yeah. What's it called? Leprosy. Because it has bacon.
Oh.
Bacon.
Really good? Was it better than the other day?
Yeah. It's
more like the all right. Wow, Mia's chowing down on that. What do you think there, Daniel?
It's very delicious. Everyone should try some.
What do you think, Juan? Was it good?
Very delicious. Everyone should try some.
Michael, was it good?
It was especially delicious.
Everyone should try some?
Everyone in this place should try some and out of this place.
What do you think, Mom? Was it better than the one for Christmas Eve? Good.